Princess! There you are! Yeah, I knew you would not be escaping my castle, even if you were let out of your cage. Wanna know how I know? We're in space! Anyway, it's showtime! You wanna know what's just infuriating? Mario's really, really close to rescuing Eldstar, the first Star Spirit. What's even worse is, since it's the first Star Spirit, I guarded it with the dumbest minions of all time! I mean, they couldn't even kill Mario using cannons! Nope, the dude just walked in, got hit in the face with a few bullets, and survived! Meanwhile, Koopa Troopa over here dies if he touches any and all fire. I'm pyrophobic! So, of course, I don't want Mario to defeat the Koopa Bros, and I'm not gonna let him. Nope, I'm gonna use my magic wand that lets me do anything I want to the Koopa Bros! Or anything else for that matter. Now, I only get one chance to do this, so I need to be precise and careful, even though it's way more fun to just go in and start messing stuff up. So, let's analyze the first part of this battle and look for any weaknesses that I can exploit. So, first of all, I actually take offense to this terrible mechanical version of myself. I mean, I don't really look that ugly, do I? Yes, you do look as ugly as that. In fact, you look worse.
What?
I'll get to you when I get to you. So this terrible version of myself has 10 HP. It also has 1 point of defense, and its only attack is a slapping attack. If I'm being honest, it's a pretty wimpy attack. I mean, you would probably need to put in effort to make getting hit in the face with a wooden brick only deal 1 HP of damage. For comparison, a bee sting in this game is 6 HP of damage. So, how much damage should it do? Well, let's find out! Hey, Lemmy! Get over here!
What is it, King Dad?
I want you to hit yourself in the face with this, it's for science.
Can do!
Ooh. Oh, look! 4 damage! Are you okay, Lemmy?
Of course I am! I do that all the time!
Okay... So, Fake Me now does 4 HP of damage. Star Rod, do your stuff! Anyway, the Koopa Idiot Bros missed one major aspect of me when they made that stupid costume. Look at those horns. They're dull. Now look at my horns. See? Look at them. Aren't they amazing? They're super sharp! And as such, Mario should feel pain when he jumps on them. Unfortunately, all sharp things in Paper Mario only do 1 HP of damage, so I guess my horns are only as sharp as Goomba spikes. So that makes me angry! But at least Mario has lost his ability to jump on that insulting depiction of me. Now there's one more thing that I need to deal with. That dumb, stupid hammer of stupidity that is stupid and dumb. Well, Fake Me already has 1 defense, so what if he... I don't know. Had 2 defense! Now Mario can't deal any damage! Well, Mario. Good luck, loser. So, time to watch Bowser get super angry, like he wasn't already. Hello there, I'm Rex, and I show all you beautiful audience members how Mario can get out of these traps. Why? Well, as Kenzie Plays says, Insane Bowser is the funniest Bowser. So I try to incite Insane Bowser. How am I not dead yet? So, let's look at all of Mario's attack options.
We can jump if we want to, we can leave your friends behind, but Bowser's got spikes, and if he's got spikes, well he ain't no friend of mine. For he deals 1 damage, and that is not very nice. I'm dragging out the song way too long, so I should really stop.
You should stop. You should stop. Yeah, I'm done with that. But that means that Mario not only takes damage from regular jumping, but also all of those jump-related badges that he has equipped, thus making those badges worthless. That leaves the plumber with only the hammer, and guess what? It does nothing due to that defense increase.
Yup! Wah-ha-ha! Mario can't do anything!
Hold it. There's one more badge in Koopa Bros. Fortress. Near the Bridge of Bullet Bill Boys, there is a bomb blocking a badge. Editor, it's not 2017 anymore. Anyway, guess what? That badge is Hammer Charge. Hammer Charge is nice. Hammer Charge is good. Hammer Charge is Mario's ticket out of here. If the plumber in red uses Hammer Charge, the hammer will deal 2 extra damage the next time it is used.
But Rex, Bowser 3 question marks deals 4 damage now. Mario no longer has 10 turns to waste charging and attacking. He needs to do this quickly.
Well, that brings me to another great thing about Hammer Charge. It stacks. That means that if you're charged and you opt to charge again instead of attack or whatever, two more damage will be added to the hammer. So every time Mario uses hammer charge, the hammer gains 2 power. After 5 charges, the hammer will deal 10 damage to fake Bowser, killing it. Also, it's really odd seeing 10 HP of damage being dealt in Chapter 1. And, now Mario's only left with 5 HP. Yikes. Does someone need a hug?
Don't push me, Koopa Troopa!
I suppose I should channel this rage that I have towards furthering my actual goals instead of beating up the people that respect me. Sorry, Koopa Troopa!
Ladies and gentlemen, my face has gone completely numb, and so has all the rest of me. Hooray!
Anyway, I still have a chance to win, and that is the final showdown against the regular Koopa Bros. So one thing you might notice right away about the Koopa Bros is their complete lack of protection. I mean, Mario can jump on them, and he can hammer them. Well, not anymore! You see, I've recently purchased this case of Volt Shrooms from... actually, I think I get in legal trouble if I said where I purchased these from. Wait, no I wouldn't, I am the law. It doesn't matter. What does matter is I have Volt Shrooms, and I'm going to beam their powers to the Koopa Bros. What? Beaming mushroom powers? Are you all right in the head, Bowser? Am I ever? No, I'm never all right. And yep, I'm beaming mushroom powers. Pew! Pew! Now if Mario jumps on my gloriously stupid ninja morons, I mean minions, he will still take damage! It's the Electrified Koopa Bros! Now I still haven't done anything about that infernal hammer! And it's a good thing that the spear guy exists. Mario takes damage whenever he tries to hammer the spear guy if the spear guy is holding his spear forward. And Mario doesn't even get to attack when that happens. So I'm going to beam that power to the Koopa Bros as well!
How are you gonna do that, Lord Bowser? The spear guys, have spears. The Koopa Bros do not have spears. How are you going to go about giving the Koopa Bros spear powers without spears?
Don't question it, just know that I can do it. Ignorance is bliss.
You're scaring me, dude.
I scare everyone. I mean, look at me. My teeth are as big as my eyes! Anyway, now Mario has no safe way left to hurt the Koopa Bros! And he probably wants to conserve the tiny amount of HP that he has left, so it's highly unlikely now that he would go about jumping on them or hammering them! But just in case Mario does deal damage to the Koopa Bros, I'm going to be sending them some of my special random healing shakes! What do these shakes do, you may ask? Well, they do exactly what's on the can, they heal you. Randomly, and it seems like they heal you pretty often as well. Now I am positive that Mario has no chance. Like, I don't think I've ever been this confident in my plans ever. And that means that the giant Mario-sized weight has finally been lifted off of my shoulders! Hey Junior, we're going out to the park to have a picnic. Make sure to let the rest of the Koopalings and Peach know. And no, it's not for anything evil, it's to celebrate the fact that my nemesis is pretty much gone! I've been looking forward to this day for years! No more needing to come up with crazy plans to thwart him! Would you look at that? Bowser's actually happy for once in his life. Even though Mario can survive this. Should I explain how Mario can survive this? Yeah, I should. Bowser's still evil and he's still got a princess captive. So, Mario enters this phase of the battle with 5 HP. The very next turn, the Koopa Bros hit for 4, meaning that Mario basically starts off this phase of the battle in peril. And if you were going to say use close call, well, Bowser got rid of the close call badge back in the prologue. Here's a picture of Mario's current badges if you're curious. Now, I need to start by saying that Cooper is a boss. This young Koopa, not Troopa, is able to attack the Koopa Bros scot-free. He attacks in his shell, which shields him not only from impalement, but also electrocution. So it's pretty safe to say that Cooper is really great for this boss battle. Also, if you were going to use Bombette, well, in the last episode, Bowser made us that whenever you attack with Bombette, it can either crash the game or harm Mario, so she's out of the picture. As for Mario, peril is bad, and he's going to have to eat the Jelly Ultras that he has in his inventory. Now, don't get too excited about the words Jelly Ultra. Remember, Bowser's got pretty much everything under his control, so Jelly Ultras are now basically regular mushrooms that also poison you. This happened in an earlier episode. And because they poison you, this puts Mario in what I like to call Jelly Ultra addiction. Now, he needs to eat a Jelly Ultra every few turns or else he will get withdrawal symptoms, the most noticeable one being instant death. Yup, Mario's got a drug addiction now. How fantastic. Now, we ideally would want to take out a single Koopa Bro in as few turns as possible, rather than trying to attack all of them equally. Why? For one, they heal themselves. A lot. And two, the more bros there are, the more damage Mario takes from the spin attack. Also, even though the Koopa Bros are electrified, Mario should still strongly consider using Power Jump. It will deal 4 damage to a flipped bro, and 3 damage to an unflipped bro. This gives Mario a massive advantage. Anyway, let's just roll the clips of this battle being beaten. Great to finally live a Mario-free existence. Well, for me, it's just nice to finally see you act genuinely happy and not angry all the time. What? What was that? I feel a disturbance. No! Stop! Please, no! Cut that out! Cut that out! Stop it! No! No! Oh, stop your whining, you big loser! So, I guess this is the end of the video, since Bowser's too sad to do an outro. Poor guy. But he's still a horrible evil monster, don't get me wrong. And yeah, remember to stay away from the path of evil, and I'll see all of you beautiful audience members later!
With my magic book, I'll shower those clumsy lizards. With my power, I'm sure dinosaur land is nothing but fossil fuel. My only problem with these spells is that I know not what they tell, so every hex leaves me perplexed and all I want are those plumbing fools.
Princess Bell, you're not so clever. All your words are alphabet soup. You should tell me better.
I'll say it again!
Ignorance is bliss.
Haven't you heard? A picture's worth a thousand words.